5.
The best
of the best.
We count them down each week on Cartoon Cartoons. The top 5.
Sunday night at 9 on Cartoon Network.
Adventure Time deserves a spot on this list. Not only was it such an important and influential show in Cartoon Network's history, but it's also such an incredibly creative and memorable one. It built a world with dozens of strange people and places, like a horse that spends his whole life rolling around on a beach ball, or a version of the underworld that is one nearly endless line. But it was so invested in developing it and its characters that I couldn't help but be mesmerized by it. The Land of Ooo is a remarkably weird world, but the show tries to explain that weirdness and give everything a purpose, no matter how strange it may seem. Honestly, the show kind of faltered when it put too much effort into trying to make some things make sense, especially when it only started doing this midway through the series. But with how massive the show's universe has almost always been, I have to give the crew some respect for at least trying to make the world more than just a nonsensical candy-coated mess. The cast of this series was also very diverse and just fun to watch. Characters like Marceline, Jake, and Bimo were always entertaining, even if they weren't going on adventures and were just chilling out. Most of the characters have also gotten a lot of development since the start of the series. For example, Ice King just seems like this grouchy old goof in season 1, but he becomes a million times more interesting when you learn about his past, and how what's keeping him alive is also making him more and more insane. Even though this backstory is given to a super quirky character, the show doesn't forget both sides of Ice King. This makes him an interesting wildcard and another one of my favorite characters. I've complained about the show introducing way too many unnecessary characters before, but there really is a character for everyone here. Adventure Time can balance light and dark story ideas really well. Seasons 2 through the first half of 5 hit that sweet spot between silly and serious and produced hit after hit episode. In season 7, the show was also able to bounce back from being mediocre, and while there are still duds here and there afterwards, I admire this show for regaining most of its former quality, as that's something not a lot of other shows can do. Bottom line, this series was and is bursting with creativity, lore, and great stories. It's not perfect, but it's something that I always come back to, just to get another taste of the wonderfully clever and bizarre world that is Adventure Time.
Adventure Time!
New episode Thursday night at 7, 6 Central, only on Cartoon Network.
After looking through Cartoon Network's past, I can say there are plenty of shows there that I enjoyed watching, but the one show that always truly stood out to me was Courage the Cowardly Dog.
We interrupt this program to bring you Courage the Cowardly Dog Show, starring Courage the Cowardly Dog!
You have your three main characters, that being Courage, our protagonist, the easily scared dog that's always put into terrifying situations and has trouble communicating with humans, Muriel, the sweet elderly woman whom is often saved by Courage, and lastly Eustace, the grumpy old man with resentment for Courage. He is also sometimes the villain. Courage is not, and never was, one of the funniest shows on the network, though it did have lots of hilarious moments.
Boys, we are going on vacation.
Yes!
Blah, blah, blah. I'm not getting out of this chair. Nope, not getting out of this chair.
No, the reason I like Courage so much is because of the creepy elements, as well as the storytelling, of course. You've likely all heard of the King Ramsay Return the Slab moment and the trumpet moment, but this isn't a show that has a few messed up moments sprinkled in throughout the series like SpongeBob. This is Courage. This show strives on having weird creatures, environments, and situations. It can have an episode entirely in creepy rhyme a la Freaky Fred, or an episode where a zombie director slash writer tries to resurrect his old serial killer buddy from when they were alive so they can film themselves eating Muriel. Remind me of how this is a kid's show? The animation, while it might not seem like anything truly impressive at first, is great at setting an ominous feeling. The show occasionally mixes different types of animation in with its usual style, and because of that, things in a different style feel out of place, which really helps boost that eerie and sometimes flat-out terrifying feel the show is going for.
Return the slab.
What?
Return the slab. Oh, suffer my curse.
The music is also fantastic, though you would really need to hear it as I can't really describe music to you. Behind all of the weirdness in Courage, there are some truly beautiful moments like in Last of the Star Makers, or some very serious real-life issues tackled such as in The Mask. This is also a series that was consistently fantastic throughout its run, from the beginning to the end. Sure, there may have been a few duds in there, but for the most part, this series was absolutely phenomenal. If you like shows with a creepy factor, well-done morals, and sometimes even some pretty emotional episodes, then I'd recommend Courage. And I'd highly recommend it if you're looking for a cartoon able to tick all of those boxes.
Crazy weather we've been having, huh?
Courage the Cowardly Dog, premiering November 12th at 9 in Cartoon Cartoon Friday. Shake courage, shake.
This is my school, Elmore Junior High, and this is the story of my life, starring the Wattersons as the Wattersons. Tobias Wilson as Tobias. Nigel Brown as the principal. Hector Schottenheim as Carrie Kruger as Carrie. This guy as this guy. And introducing all my other friends in the amazing world of...
Ugh, forget it. Who's gonna watch that?
The Amazing World of Gumball. True to its name, this show is indeed amazing. There's a reason... well, multiple reasons, why Gumball is one of Cartoon Network's most successful shows of this generation, if not the network's lifespan. The mixed media aesthetics are some of the finest you will ever see in animation. On a surface level, the usage of hand-drawn, flash, live-action, CGI, puppets, claymation, and so on and so forth may seem discordant, but they seamlessly blend so well with each other that you're convinced that they belong together on the same screen when they otherwise shouldn't. One can only imagine the budget that goes into a single episode of the show. And the writing. By God, the writing. If the show doesn't make you laugh with its brand of physical humor, which itself is top-notch thanks to the animators using the different styles to their advantage, then you'll be surprised to find how clever and on-the-ball the writing is.
Only a small percentage of the world doesn't age. Mostly people on TV.
This is a show that knows no boundaries. It has no qualms about what it wants to be. It's meta, topically and culturally relevant without the commonly attributed caveat of being forced or cringeworthy. And the way these meta-level topical and cultural acknowledgements are interwoven into an episode's plot is quite masterful, if I say so myself. Gumball's writing is accentuated by a charming, colorful, and likable cast of characters, the titular character especially standing out for being a prime example of a kid character done properly, and his family being one of the most endearing in animation, if not television. Favorable comparisons have been made between Gumball and a few adult-oriented cartoons like Rick and Morty because of the social commentary and subtext, and that Gumball is more or less an adult cartoon trapped in the body of a children's cartoon. That could explain why it's so unabashedly cynical when you look past its dreamlike exterior. On that note, I'm glad that Gumball has that certain contrast that seems to be lacking in cartoons nowadays. We could use more of it. Perhaps the most amazing thing about this show though, and it's saying something given that Gumball already has so much going for it, is the sheer gamble of it all. It was a gamble for the creator Ben Beaucollet, and for Cartoon Network itself, being the very first greenlit series from Cartoon Network Development Studio Europe, and an amalgamation of Ben Beaucollet's previous advertising endeavors. Needless to say, the gamble more than paid off, and both The Amazing World of Gumball and Ben Beaucollet have cemented a place for themselves amongst animation's upper echelon.
A new series coming Mondays in May on Cartoon Network.
Now, before I say anything, I do understand that this show is flawed. There are some unenjoyable episodes, occasionally the pacing can be pretty flimsy, and the lack of model sheets. While I don't hate the problems that absence causes as much as everyone else, it can often break the show's immersion. But personally, I can look past those flaws because this show is fantastic. When the art is done right, they really get it right. When they need to show a character's struggle, they go all the way. The songs? Impeccable. The story? Creative and masterfully executed. The characters? Pretty much all of them are a joy to watch. The humor? Almost always hilarious and well-balanced with the emotion. I think it seriously deserves a spot on the list, as it does so many things remarkably well.
Steven Universe, weeknights at 6:30, 5:30 Central, starting next week on Cartoon Network.
See you later. After you, sir.
When I think of Cartoon Network, I think of lying on the couch one Saturday afternoon, turning on the TV and watching my favorite cartoons. Cartoon Network was the channel I would watch the most, and it remains to be my favorite cartoon channel to this day. I first had access to Cartoon Network around 2007, so while I still watched Cartoon Network shows from the 90s, my fondest memories were watching shows that were still airing at the time, such as Buster's Home for Imaginary Friends, Codename Kids Next Door, Camp Leslo, The Grim Adventures of Billy and Mandy, and especially the original Ben 10. But my favorite Cartoon Network show, not only from that era, but of all time, would have to be Ed, Edd n Eddy. Antonucci was dead to create an animated children's show, which resulted in the creation of what remains to this day the longest-running Cartoon Network original series. Ed, Edd n Eddy followed the stories of three boys who lived in a cul-de-sac who get into wacky adventures while scamming a few friends along the way. These boys consisted of Ed, a strong but not-so-bright screwball, Double D, a fragile nerd, and Eddie, an arrogant, money-hungry jerk who's somehow still lovable. Not only were the main characters entertaining, but the side characters were just as, if not more entertaining, than the three main characters. I enjoyed Rolf's weird foreign ways, Jimmy's scrawny moments with Sarah's bratty shenanigans, Johnny's denseness, and the Kanker sisters' barbaric tendencies, just to name a few. The show's use of slapstick and exaggerated sound effects gives the show a fun and iconic trademark that wasn't found in many other shows at the time.
I win again, Double D!
We are playing X's and O's, aren't we, Ed?
The best part about this show, in my eyes, is how the show can appeal to people both young and old, with its hilarious scenarios and more mature moments. Although Cartoon Network has put out more amazing cartoons since the end of the show, I'll always love Ed, Edd n Eddy out of every Toon CN ever put out.
You know what they say? A little childhood trauma builds character.
Ed, Edd n Eddy, coming this January to Cartoon Network.
And that about wraps up this video. Thank you to everyone who took the time to make and submit an entry for this collab. There was a ton of effort put into even the ones that didn't make it onto the list, and I'm very sorry that I had to make so many cuts. If you saw anything that you liked, I really hope you check out the channels featured here. I'll leave a link in the description to a playlist I put together of my personal favorite videos from the channels who contributed to this video. Very special thanks goes out to Captain Bizarre, who helped me edit half of this video in order for me to get it out on time. He's a great dude. And you can also check out his channel in the description, where he posts old commercial breaks from Cartoon Network and Adult Swim. That's all I have to say for now. I'm Nintendo, and happy birthday, Cartoon Network. Here's to 25 more great years.